Good morning, Grade 2. Today, we are going to learn a new topic from Unit 8. So, last class, we have already discussed about water, the importance of water. Now, you all know that water is precious. So, in this chapter, we will be discussing about the different sources of water. Water is an important part of our life. We cannot live without water. We all need water to survive. Tell me, kids, what are the different uses of water? We need water for our daily use, such as drinking, cooking, cleaning, bathing, washing. Yes? Yes. Even plants need water. Animals need water and also birds need water. So last class we have already discussed about the use of the needs of water. Now, where do we get all this water from? Think about it. Where do we get all this water from? We get mainly from the rain. So the rain water gets collected in rivers, streams, lakes, ponds. So this rainwater which gets collected in streams, lakes and all, it is stored in tanks and reservoirs. Can you see here? Tanks. Yes, have you seen the tank which is built up on the roof tops? Yes, so you all know what is a tank. Now have you heard about the word reservoirs? You can see here the picture of a reservoir. Yes? It's a place where the water is stored. Here, in a reservoir, the water is stored. Yes. And then it is carried to different places through water pipes. So, what is a reservoir? Water stored in a large amount. From there, it is carried to different places through water pipes. And then it finally reaches our homes and water comes out through our water tanks. So what are reservoirs? Reservoirs are places where water is stored. Yes. And then it is carried to different places through water pipes, big water pipes. It finally reaches our homes and water comes out through water tanks. The water that we see on the surface of the ground is called surface water. So how is surface water stored? It is stored in dams, large dams and also in canals. So the surface water, that is the water that we see on the surface of the ground, is stored in large dams and canals. Some water, when it rains, what happens is water seeps into the ground. So water that collects under the ground is called ground water. So what do you mean by ground water? The water which is collected beneath the ground. Now how do we make use of this water? We make wells to use this water by using a hand pump or a tube well. This is underground source of water. Today we studied two sources of water. Yes, the surface water and also the underground water. Surface water usually we store it in large dams and canals. And underground water is made use by, yes, we make a well. Yes, or a tube well. Now, as I said, water comes from several sources. All this water may be impure. So, what should we do? We must always drink clean water. Why? Otherwise, what will happen? Or else we will fall sick. So, treatment of water is very necessary because we collect water from different sources. It can be from the streams, it can be from the rivers, yes, it can be underground water. So whichever source it is, we must ensure that we only drink pure water. Treatment of water is therefore necessary. The water that is stored in tanks and reservoirs is filtered and disinfected. What do you mean by disinfected? We make it germ-free and pure before it reaches our home. So the water which is collected in these tanks and in this reservoir, yes, it is made germ-free to make the water pure. And only then it reaches our homes through the tanks. So kids, here I have given you a picture of the treatment of the water. Can you see here? Before they reach our homes. In this is called a treatment plant. So here the water is disinfected. The germs are removed from the water and then they are carried through big pipes and finally they reach our homes.